Hello friends. In this video, I will teach you how to create different types of shadows for characters or shapes. In order to create a shadow for the character, I first select the main layer of the character, which is a bone layer. If I open this bone layer, you can see that all the other layers of this character are inside it. I double click on this bone layer and in the shadows section we can access the shadow settings. I activate the shadow on option and press the apply button. Now I press the control button and R to see a preview of the character. You can see that a shadow has been created for the character. I increase the offset number and apply. In the scene, I press the control button and R. Now you can see that the distance between the shadow and the character has increased. So increasing the offset number increases the distance between the shadow and the character. Using the blur option, we can increase or decrease the blur of the shadow. I set the blur value to 50 and hit the apply button. In the scene, I press the control button and R. You can see that the shadow is very blurred. I set the blur number to 30. Now the amount of shadow blur has decreased. I set the blur option to 10, which is a good number. Using the shadow color option, we can change the color of the shadow. I choose red. And with Ctrl and R, I see the preview. Now the shadow color is red. Or you can choose other colors. From this part, we can increase or decrease the opacity of the color. And we can change the shadow direction from here. Ctrl and R to see the changes. If we activate the shadow threshold option, the shadow mode will change and have sharper edges. We can change the shadow expansion value. I activate the shading on option. I press the apply button. And in the scene, I press the control button and R. You can see that there is a glow on the character that makes the animation and the character come alive. Here we can change the offset value and you can see the result. We can change the amount of blur shading. If I choose the number 1 for blur, he can see that the blur of the shading is reduced a lot. There are other options, like the shadow section that I explained, and it doesn't need to be explained anymore. By changing the numbers, you can see different results. You can also change the shading color and see the result. In this section, we can create three-dimensional shadows. If I activate the shadow perspective option and press the control button and R, a 3D shadow will be created. We can see this shadow better by using the orbit tool. Now if I change the place of origin and press the apply button and see the preview. The shadow is created where I put the origin. So, in this case, by changing the origin, you can also change the location of the shadow. Again, you can change the amount of opacity and color of the shadow. By changing the scale value, we make the shadow size smaller or larger. I will change it to see the result. We can change the amount of shear and see the result. After making the changes, I click OK. But there is another type of shade that has many uses. To create this type of shadow, I take a duplicate of the main bone layer of the character. Now we have two similar characters. I want to consider the bottom layer as a shadow. I rotate the character with the transform tool. Do not forget that the slider must be in zero frame. I double click on this layer and activate the colorize layer option. I choose a dark color for the shadow and reduce the opacity. I press the apply button. I move the camera back a little so that the character and the shadow are in the camera frame. Now if I press the control button and R, you can see that the shadow is created for this character. I rotate the shadow with the rotate tool and change its location with the transform tool. Now, by pressing the control button and R, we can see the result and the shadow is well created for us. If I move the camera, the direction of the shadow changes as the camera moves. We can also create another shadow for the character. There are two other very important points. I choose another character. Do not forget that for this type of shadow, you must first make the animation without shadow and after finishing the work, create a shadow for the character. The reason is that when you duplicate the character to create a shadow, all the keyframes are copied for the shadow so that the shadow moves with the character itself. The next point is that we can make the shadow bigger or smaller with the transform tool. Thank you for being with me until the end of this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Bye until the next video.